Of all the torments in this world, a neighbour's worse than art. The chorus things from day to day and doesn't care a straw whether you get them back or not, if it just pleases them. They're not afraid to ask for more, they never know no shame. We've got a neighbour of this kind, she'll come and borrow clears and pots and pans and kettles, and she'll keep the thing for days. If we invite a friend to dine, we'll hardly get a smell. When in she comes to borrow this or that, does neighbour Nell. Me doubter has a nice young man, and soon they'll marry me. So often he comes to the house to have a cup of tea. He's always so polite and prim, religious in his ways. Particular what he sees or hears and careful what he sees. But still no neighbour doesn't care if he be out or in. She'll come and beg 3 halfpence to get half a glass of gin. I've seen him quite disgusted, like his brows both rose and fell. Neighbour Nell, quite bold and brazen as can be, says she, excuse me coming in, some company I've got. Women folks, I'd be obliged if you'd lend us the pot.
She says, they're bringing in a case of Parkinson's. Why, thank God, says the other one, I'm fed up with all this bloody Brunel.
But anyway, lads and lasses, lads and lasses, what about another song, eh? Another song, eh? What'll it be? One of the old feelings? That's a good idea. Keep your feet still. Now, you all know this chorus. So what about it, lads and lasses? Join in on the chorus.
Oh, Johnny and Bob Johnson both lay in one bed in that little lodging house down by the shore. But afore there'd been an oak, men had waken up and thought instead of snore. Keep your feet still, Johnny, and he left me hanging through the wind. One day I'll be standing through the wind. So give us that big comfort, give us a good night.
Consumption, they call it, you know. Mind, nobody's told us to me face, least of all the doctor, but I just have to look at me reflection in the mirror. Funny, isn't it? How other, only other people die of consumption, not you, just other people. Eh? It was me father died of it, you know. I've told you that, haven't I? Right? Huh. He was 31. My Uncle Ned was 32, and I'll have reached the grand old age of 34 next November. How's Bella going to manage? Same way as my mum, I suppose. Best way she can. Are you getting maudlin, Joe? No, I'm being realistic. Ah, shut up, man! Get me a realistic streak from my mum, you know. She always said I'd come to a sticky end, but she didn't mean so ill health.